Well, that's the spoof from the Second City, folks. The reality is just as clear to see, I'm afraid. I'm looking at the New York Times back page. Beautiful picture. We will get it done. We will make this right, with a lovely picture of a cleanup crew and berms. With me, Mike Papantonio, co-host of Ring of Fire. He's representing some of the shrimpers and fisher people in their lawsuits against BP. Mike, why on earth should I or anyone else believe that BP will get this done or make anything right? And where are these berms?
Well, I always come back to the basics. You have to say, can I believe a felon? This is a company that agrees that they are a felon. They've had to plead guilty to felony charges. They've also had to plead guilty to price fixing, where they were fined $350 million. So you start there, and then you say, okay, well, what did they do after that when this took place? Well, they lied to us about there was a leak at all. Then the leak was 25,000 gallons a day, which was a lie. And then we learn it's, you know, our people today say it could be as high as 4 million gallons a day at some point in this whole thing. So, yeah, I mean, you have to look at this people like a person. I mean, if you got a liar, felon, a criminal that's sitting there talking to you, you have to say, well, you know, maybe I ought to reconsider what they're saying or overconsider what they're saying.
Well, and then there's the company they keep. We found out this weekend they just hired, or they have hired, former Cheney spokesperson Ann Colton to represent them.
Right. And Ann Colton, you know the story. Ann Colton was the person who was behind closed doors with Dick Cheney and Randall Lutey of the Mineral Management for 100 days, along with BP and Chevron. I mean, all the major oil companies were there. And for 100 days, we don't know what they talked about. But Colton is the person who was out front supporting. She was the mouthpiece for Cheney when we tried to get the minutes from those meetings. She was, Ann Colton was the person who was there. So is it a coincidence that now she's the mouthpiece for BP? There are no coincidences in politics, Laura, as you know. There's no coincidence to all of this. So this story just continues getting more interesting. That's why we're filing a RICO case on this, a RICO case in this process that is going to show we want some of these questions answered. What happened behind those closed doors, and how does it tie up to the disaster, the catastrophe that we're facing today?
Now, a RICO case alleges conspiracy. Who's part of that conspiracy in your view?
Well, the conspiracy is part of Mineral Management. It's part of Mineral Management. It's part of other people who influenced Mineral Management. Those names will be named as this progresses. But I'm not the only one thinking about this. If you don't think the Justice Department is looking at this right now, saying, gee whiz, how could this not be a RICO case? I would just be amazed.
Well, let's switch to what you think the administration's doing. I mean, the president maybe sounded, I don't know, one iota a bit more miffed this weekend about not only the $50 million on TV ads that the BP is spending, but also that $10.5 billion they paid out to stockholders in dividends. At the same time, you can't help but wonder, what's he doing and getting done? And what could be being done?
Looking mad and sounding mad, you know, it's his long suit. He's a great speaker. He's a great orator. But right now, we all know, anybody who's followed this, we know that he has a very specific statute that he has access to. It's U.S. Code 33-134. He could nationalize part of this company if he wanted to. And the reason he would do that is because we know the only solution is to bring in super tankers. Super tankers can take this stuff right up out of the Gulf. They can process it and haul it away. The super tankers aren't here because BP vetoed bringing those super tankers in from the North Sea. This is exactly what happened in Saudi Arabia when they had a Gulf spill that was 700 million gallons. They brought in the tankers. Each tanker holds 80 million gallons, and they cleaned it up. 85% of it was cleaned up.
Let's go.
So he could go do that, is what I'm trying to say, Laura.
Now, one of the things I'd like to see also is some of that oil that's being captured courtesy of this new container cap coming into at least the National Reserve. But I'm hearing BP is going to be preserving that captured oil for its own profits. Is that true?
It makes sense that it should be. It makes perfect sense that we ought to benefit from this catastrophe right now. You pointed out just a minute ago, $10 billion paid to stockholders. Now we hear that the oil that's coming out of here, at the very least, this ought to be some kind of peace offering by BP. But they really don't care. That's what everybody misses. They think we're dealing with a normal person here. You have to look at it. They're not. This is a sociopath corporation. I don't know why people can't get their hands around that. Kyra Phillips with CNN. It's almost like she had Stockholm syndrome. She's like this embedded PR machine right there out on the rig with, you know, with Thad Allen, who's supposed to be the mouthpiece for the American public. He's now the mouthpiece for BP. So the reason people don't understand what a corrupt thug, what a sociopath this corporation is because you have people like Kyra Phillips that are all telling the nice little stories and, gee, let me tell you the background of how hard they're working to get this cleaned up. It's all misdirection. I swear to God, it's almost like she has the same kind of Stockholm syndrome that Haley Barbour has, only Haley Barbour is doing it because Haley Barbour's been paid so much money by the industry.
Now, Haley Barbour is out there saying, you know, we could lose more as a state in economic losses if we sustain or maintain this ban on drilling. That seems to be the new PR line. The locals are more worried about the drilling ban than they are about the damage. What do you make of that?
That's why the rest of the country. So, you know, I don't know if you've been on the internet lately looking at the comments on some of these blogs, but you have people that are non-red staters. They're not in Texas, Louisiana, Alabama, Mississippi and Florida. And they're saying, well, hell with you guys. You're the ones that wanted all of this. You wanted the drill, baby, drill. You voted Republican. That's why you have the red state. You thought George Bush was a genius. You believe Dick Cheney. You're a teabagger nation down there. You wanted all this. By God, you can have it. That's already developing. Now, when a guy like Haley Barbour comes out and says something like that, it just makes it worse. He is a fool. He's a buffoon. Everybody down here knows he's a buffoon. But the problem is that's the kind of politics we live with. The new pitch is, gee whiz, environmentalists are responsible for this because if they would let us drill in 3 miles or 5 miles from the beach, we can handle this. Well, you can tell how ridiculous the argument is, but you have the Jindals and the Barbours and the Rick Perrys and the Bob Rileys from Alabama making ridiculous arguments like this. You can't forget where we are. We are in Teabagger Central. Look at a map. They're all red states. They all voted exclusively Republican my God, I can't even remember the last election. They didn't. And so now the rest of the country is saying, you guys wanted this. You know, you wanted this. Here it is.
Well, it's we're not saying that, Mike. We're saying we want to hear more from you in a couple of weeks. And I want to thank you for being our go-to person on this story.